Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be filming this very smoky, dark, fall makeup look. And guess what? It's with all affordable drugstore makeup items, well, most of it besides my eyebrows and my lid primer, but that is about it. Everything else is affordable and drugstore, so if you want to learn how to get this smoky fall look, then keep on watching. So we're going to prime our eyelids first. I'm trying to do like an all affordable like makeup fall tutorial, but I don't. Everything that I've picked up is mostly drugstore and affordable, except a couple of items like my brows. I'm using my Benefit eyebrow products that I usually use, and then my eye primer. I don't have any eye primers from the drugstore, so recommend me some good ones. I really want to try the Wet n Wild one, so let me know if you've tried that and if you have oily lids. So my MAC Prep and Prime 24 Hour Extended Eye Base. I'm going to use this to prime my lids, obviously. Now I'm going to go take my foundation that I'm using today. I'm actually going to be mixing two, but I'm just going to use the Maybelline Fit Me foundation to use on my eyes, taking the Morphe M224. I'm going to apply that. Ooh, that's a lot. Whoops. I'm going to apply that how I usually apply it on both of my eyes. Does that look a little bit crazy, but that's okay. I'm just going to blend it out with my Beauty Blender. So, oh my god, my hair is actually dry for once. Usually I like take a shower and film a look, but this is actually my second video that I'm attempting to film. I usually only like to film one video a day, because then I feel like, because I only want to upload quality videos. And then I'm going to take my Morphe E20 brush and just tap that into the eyelid. Or my eyes and not my eyelid, sorry. So now we're gonna move on to the eyes. I really wanna do something like a smoky eye, but shimmery, like a matte smoky, and then apply some shimmer on top. So I am gonna refer back to my NYX Ultimate Multi Finish Shadow Palettes. I love these ones, my Sugar High and Warm Rust. I've used these in videos before, so you've seen them in action. Wow, I'm like really red right now, but that's okay. I'm gonna take my Sugar High palette and I'm gonna go in with this shade right here. It's just like a mauve-y type of shade, and I'm gonna take a clean blending brush. This is my Morphe M441, so I'm gonna take this matte shade right here and apply that all over my lid, used as a transition shade. I just want this to be kind of like a blown out smoky eye, so blend. Blend and blend, my friends. It's okay if it gets on the lid. I'm actually gonna apply some on my lid. Look, I just nicked this eyeshadow. Oh my gosh, my nail literally dug right into it. Taking my Bedellium Tools 776, and I'm going into my Warm Rust palette and using this matte, like mahogany shade, I guess you could say, and I'm popping that into the crease to deepen it up. Oh, that's what a traumatic event that happened on my eyeshadow palette. So I'm just gonna focus that in the crease. So I'm focusing this into my crease first. As you can see, like, I'm literally digging into my eye. Or my crease, not my eye. This Royal and Langnickel eyeshadow brush. It is the BMD466. Going back with my Sugar High palette, I'm going to take this deep purple right here and apply this all over my lids. Take this Morphe M551. You can see it looks like a black eye, so I'm gonna blend it out. This is a clean brush. Taking my Bedellium Tools, I'm gonna go back with that mahogany shade, and I'm gonna use that to blend as well, but add a little bit more of that color. I feel like on my right eye, I really lost it when I applied the dark plum color. Okay, so I'm gonna take this brush. I'm gonna use one side. This is the same Royal and Lang Nickel brush. I'm gonna go back with my Sugar High palette. So I use this deeper shade. I'm gonna use this metallic shade from this. It's like the same color but different finish. I'm gonna take this one right here and I'm gonna apply that onto the lid. I'm gonna take my ColourPop Aquamarine Setting Spray. Put that on the lid. You could have stopped at the All Matte Smoky Eye, but like, look at this. I don't know if I want like my whole entire lid to be full of this, but we'll see. I'm just gently patting it on right now. I think I'm just gonna leave it like that. I'm just gonna blend it out. I'm just patting this in, like, in sparse areas. Before I move to my face, I'm gonna highlight it with my Sonia Kashuk, what is this called? Cheek Luminosity Highlighter Stick, and this is in Sparkling Sands number 45. I'm just gonna take it straight from the not my forehead and not the my whole nose, because then I'm just gonna blend it out. But I'm gonna blend it out. So for the foundation I'm using today, I'm gonna be using my Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless and my L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte in 105 Natural Beige. This is in 128. I'm gonna cover this crater on my forehead. So now I'm gonna conceal. Today I'm gonna be using my Wet n Wild concealers. I'm gonna use medium tawny. This is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus concealer. Medium tawny is kind of like a correcting shade. It's like a very, has a peachy orangey undertone. I'm also gonna take the time to carve out my shadow with this concealer. And I'm gonna blend out. I'm going to highlight. I'm going to be using my Maybelline Instant Age Rewind Dark Circle Eraser, and this is in the color Light Pale. This is one of my favorite drugstore highlighting concealers. It's just amazing. So I'm going to do my usual three. And yeah, that's basically it. To set my under eyes with the number 7 loose powder. Dust off the powder. I'm going to be using my Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Powder in 220, taking my Morphe E49 brush. I just love how it's like, just gets right in here. Look, it's the perfect shape. Okay, and then now I'm going to set my face using the same powder. This is the Morphe M551. Going to bronze up my face. I'm going to be using my number 7 bronzer in caramel. Take my Morphe M435 brush. Okay, bronzed. And now I'm going to contour. This is the NYX Highlight and Contour Pro palette. My brush into all of the shades. So I'm going to be using this Morphe brush. It's the M528, this like pointy brush. Okay, my contour is a little bit dark. I'll blend this out. So as you can see, these are really pigmented. Okay, this brush is a little too like packed for me. This is the e.l.f. blush brush. Take my Morphe E2 and I'm going to just blend anything out, anything and everything, since my contour is a little bit harsh. Using the same loose powder. And and then I'm gonna let this set and I'll be right back. I think while I'm away, I am gonna be applying some lashes. I'm gonna be using the Coco Lashes Goddess, my L'Oreal Lash Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara, and I'll be right back. So, okay, there's like so much of the powder all over me. Okay, so now I'm gonna dust it off using the same brush. As you can see, I have my lashes on already. My Coco Lashes Goddess. Ow. The eyes. That deep purple shade. Bedellium Tools 781. It's just like a fluffy pencil brush. So I'm gonna use that to smoke out the lower lash line. I'm gonna take my Morphe M441 and I'm gonna take that first shade from the Sugar High palette, the transition shade, and I'm gonna use that to blend it out. So I'm going to hold the brush like this. I'm gonna blend it out. Now I'm gonna add also some inner corner highlight. This no-named pencil brush, which I'm pretty sure is from Morphe. It looks like I have a bronzer helmet, but I swear I do not. I look really weird right now. I'm gonna go back to the Sugar High palette, take these two colors, I'm gonna mix them together, and I'm going to apply that onto my inner corners. Fall colored blush, and I want my face to be glowy. So this is the Milani Cosmetics Baked Blush in Berry Amour. It's Morphe M556 to apply it. Just swirl. These are really pigmented. Apply some highlighter using the Pixie Plus Aspen Ovoid Collection, or Collab, sorry. This is in Santorini Sunset. Just a pretty highlighter. Oh, and on the lower lash line, I applied ColourPop's Cream Gel Color in Besto, just like a purpley color to go along and like match with the purpley shade that I used. If I highlight, where's my brush? I'm taking Anastasia A23. So I grab some, I'm going to take my ColourPop Aquamarine Color, Aquamarine Crystal Setting Spray. I'm going to spray a little bit. Excuse me, I like burped in the middle of my sentence. Oh, wrong side. Do you see that? I'm so bright and pretty. My Lexi 231 small tapered brush. I'm gonna use that to highlight my cupid's eye. And now I'm going to set my eyebrows. Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer in medium brown. I'm going to use my Shocking Telescopic Extensions Mascara. So I think all that left is my lips. So I'm going to be using my NYX Lip Pencil in Deep Purple. Now, I'm not sure which one I want to take. I have two NYX Soft Matte Lip Creams. This is Copenhagen, and then this is Transylvania. I think I'm going to go with Copenhagen. Kind of want it a little bit deeper, so I'm going to mix the two. Maybe I'll put Transylvania like in the corners. Okay, so this is the first lip color because I do have another one that I want to try. They also had sent me previously the NYX Liquid Suede. That's how I don't have my lipstick on my teeth. And I want to over apply this on top, but I wanted to see how the soft matte lip creams look first. So this is how it looks like. Very vampy, fall, dark lips, smoky eyes, just lovely. So now I'm going to apply the NYX Liquid Suede Metallic Matte, and this is in the color Neat Nudes. It looks like this. I'm gonna put it right on top. I'm gonna have to cover my whole lip though. This is so, I look like I'm wearing black lipstick right now. Guys, look how cool this metallic lipstick is. I don't think my camera can catch it, but holy crap, I look so fall right now. I'm feeling it. This metallic lipstick matches my eye makeup. It really does. Okay, I have hair like all over my lashes. So this is the end of my tutorial. Oh, losing all my teeth. This is the end of my affordable drugstore fall smoky fall makeup look. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and follow me on my social media, and I'll see you in my next one.